Hey guys, Halkhan here with our friends gathered at Epic Server on the Scorched Earth map. And today I would like to showcase the Castles, Keeps, and Forts mod. We're going to build in this area I've selected here. Let me get off my dragon, or my wyvern. And we're going to build under this waterfall, okay? And I've gathered group of dinos to help me do just that. So this is going to kind of be what we're going to focus on. We're going to try to figure out a way to incorporate the natural surrounding here and build a base around it so we can kind of harness the idea of this rare commodity on this server, water, as being part of our build. All right. We're going to try to leave some of the vegetation, rocks, and trees near our build alone. So that way, once we place our foundations, they'll still be intact. And then also figure out a way to protect them from things damaging them. Like, you know, earlier this week, I broke a tree that I'd left alone for about 7 days inside my base. And then I accidentally broke it. So we're going to try to figure out a way to do that as well. What we're going to need for this build is we're going to need a masonry workbench. Okay, that's the primary thing for... Let me turn down my gamma just a little bit. All right, so we go in here, it's not so bright. It's called a masonry workbench, and it's part of the mod. All right, we need metal ingots, stone, wood, and hide. Well, I don't know if I have the hide, but maybe I've got hide on emerald. That spoiled meat will stack here in a second on its own. I do have some hide. Go ahead and grab some of that. I don't need quite that much. And I need some stone and some wood. There's our wood gatherer here. I don't need that much. I'm sure we'll need more wood later. And then stone. Well, that'd be easy. Get some stone from Baller here. Okay. Got plenty of stone. Now we can go ahead and make this table. Now you see a bunch of other mods that we use kind of in here. Just ignore those. We're not really focusing on those. I'll do things on those later, like, you know, ignore the fact that there's a Stargate there. That's what we use to travel and make things easier to get. Okay, so I think one of the first tips I'm going to give for lining up an item, because trying to put something down and making sure that it's straight or perpendicular to everything around it is tricky. So if you look here where I've got this table where I'm going to place it, you can see the line right between the legs of the foundation. Okay, it's static, it's not moving. And also between the legs, I'm going to use that green board that goes between the front two legs there, and I'm going to line it up to that line, and then I'm going to strafe. If I deviate from the line, I'm crooked. If I turn it a little bit, try again, I'm still deviating slightly, right? So I'll turn it a little bit more. And this foundation, unfortunately, isn't one of the best for having straight lines that don't deviate. But I would say that's pretty good. And now what I'll do is I'm going to go to a K, and I'm going to validate that it's straight by going to a K and doing a side. Okay, and then I'm going to move over and just try to get it right there in a corner without leaving room for walls in case I want to put walls up later. And for me, that's straight enough. And I'm pretty picky, so. Now we need to start dumping our resources in there. We'll need metal ingots, wood, thatch, and probably won't need any hide. But I've got these guys over here. They've got more resources. And we're going to need all of this. All right, so give me your stone. I don't need any sand. Thank you very much. Dump all of our stone in there. And you can just drop all your items right there because you are going to be useful later. Okay, we're going to need a lot more stone than that. Unfortunately, this mod uses a ton of resources. And that means we're going to need tons of stone and tons of metal. We're going to be getting it for days, depending on the size of our structure. I'm Let's see here. You got a lot of wood that I need, and I'll take the thatch too. Really, dude? You're just gonna sit there and swing your tail? Come on. I know. You can't help yourself. Alright. Do we got any metal on this guy? No, we don't. Alright. Give me that. Drop all this stuff. Okay. You can have some... You can have those back. Give me that. Now we're going to take him and get some metal real quick. So we're going to do a metal run. Okay, guys. We're back. We have made it back with our metal. I'm going to go here and do an unload. And let me see. Can't carry all the weight. I got a bunch of stuff, other stuff on me, which I probably don't need all of this. So we'll go ahead and clean out some of this stuff. I'll throw the thatch on there. You don't know if you'll need it or not. I don't think we use it in this mod, but it's not going to hurt. And at least if I need some thatch later, I'll know where to get it. Finish getting off what we need. We're going to scope out an area here. And we'd like to build around in such a way that we can come down here. Try to see if I can get water from here. Okay, apparently cannot get water from this. It is not, even though it has a splash effect and it's water, it's not deep enough for you to be able to get food, or food, to get a drink of water. So that means we're going to have to make sure that we incorporate this area down here in our build so we have access to water. Okay, and I want to clear out a bunch of this. So let's go ahead and make some foundations to prevent respawn of vegetation that we do want to take out. Let's go over real quick the mod and the different options that you have before we start building. I'm going to find it here in this long list of stuff. When you have this many mods, then the list tends to get pretty long. Okay, so right here at the masonry table is where the mod pack begins. All right, and in ARC, when you add mods, it puts them in the order that they're placed. If they have Ingrams, it'll put them in the order in which they are listed in your server. And so you can see that the masonry table is, you know, it costs 18, and then pretty much everything else you buy is going to be 1. You have lots of options with foundations, walls, ceiling tiles, battlements, pillars. There's only 1 pillar. You have stairs and ramps. You have a porculus. Now, I've used this in the past. I had problems with it. It would not stay functioning unless you kept picking up and putting down this power keg, which is what powers the porculus. Now, there have been updates since I used it. I haven't went back to use it. Maybe we'll try it in this video today. This is basically a stamp that you can put up, like a way to show that, you know, there's options you can change it to. It's just decoration, really. You have roof options. You have these things called gables. They basically go on stairs to make it look like the stairs are built over a solid piece. You have jail options, secret door, archways, bedding. I haven't used the stable bedding in a functional capacity, only as decorative so far. They have fireplaces that work really well. You have the option of doing a rotisserie, which will work like it's basically a wood-burning industrial stove, the one that cooks meat, that one. And then you have the cooking pot, which works as the industrial cooking stove. I guess I should look those up. We'll get back to that later because we'll probably build both of them. Chimneys, tons of options for windows. And then it ends here where the S crafting station, just before that, that's where it ends. So those are the different options we have, and we can build everything. Okay, so let's go ahead and make some foundations. We're going to start with our basic square foundations. And we'll start with 10 of them. Okay. And 10. All right. Got that in my number 9 slot. That's on my mouse. So, all right. So this rock is obviously not going anywhere. So this is going to have to be part of our build. So what I want to do is I'm going to line up this first part to incorporate making use of that rock. Now I'm also concerned about the height to make sure that my foundation will go all the way back and the floor will not pop through. Okay, and I'm actually going to come up a little bit further because I want to go to the left, and the left is a little bit higher than the right. Looks like that side, everything is lower, so this is going to be a good spot. All right, now I want to check its alignment to the wall behind me. That is not critical because it is so jagged and crooked. All right, so we're going to go ahead and call this a thing. All right. I still like the placement of the I still like the placement of our foundations. I think that'll work. I think it would look cooler had the other rocks stayed in, but you know, it's not that big of a deal. Okay, see, now it's not going to snap there. I've got a fix for that, and I'll show you how that works here in a second. Get this guy out of the way. Or maybe we'll just, like, use him. Alright, so let's see if I can get back and save some materials. Nope. Wait, yes I can. Stop. Alright, so I'm going to make myself some pillars, because I'm going to need them for building. Pillars are kind of the trick to getting foundations to snap in other locations, and I'll kind of show you how that works. This is good timing for it. Okay, so I'm obviously not going to get a foundation to snap on all of these down here, right? So what I need to do is give me this rock. Can I get a foundation to stick there? Yes. I can get it to stick everywhere except for right here. If I put down a foundation, if I put in a pillar like so, I can get a foundation to stack lower. See how I got it to, like, just drop down some? And then I can go back and I can pick up this pillar and I can go across with a lower tier here. However, we don't exactly want all of these to be down low yet, so I'm going to pick up two of these and we'll put them. I can get that one snap there. It's not going to snap up there. Okay. And let me get my animal. More vegetation clearage. If I put a pillar there, I can do this. Get to the next level. Pick up. There we go. Alright, so because of where the water's falling, I'm going to leave this completely open. Right, we're going to go over here. Can I reach you? And let's get rid of this. See what this looks like. This is probably also gonna break, so let's go ahead and get rid of that now. We're going to go over one more. Kind of come down this way. Like so. And that is going to be the area that we're going to protect. Now, I've got the ability to put some plants, so I'm going to plant some plants in there as we do more of this as we go on. Pop up there. Okay, so what I did was I had the foundations below that I had made lower, and I was able to put foundations on top because I was able to snap to the upper ones at that point. It was good enough for the mod to accept it, and that works for me. Okay, so we've laid some more foundations here. And we're getting a pretty good idea of what we want now. And let's get rid of the sand again. Okay, now the way this is looking, this area over here is higher, so if we're going to come over here and utilize this, we're going to have to go up a little bit higher. Clear out some of the space over here. Get rid of all the vegetation. Okay. And I'm almost out of foundations too. Alright, so it is not going to be a symmetrical build. I can tell you that already. So now that we've started the process of laying down our foundations, let's try to recover some of this. We don't have to have solid foundations in this entire part, okay? We need foundations basically every third tile in order for the build to stay intact, okay? What I mean by that is I can overhang two ceilings, two distance, as long as there's a foundation on the other side, and I should be good to go. So let's go ahead and make some ceiling tiles, and we'll play around with the ceilings so we can see how those can be incorporated into our build. I don't know if our build's going to go to that tree over there, but we'll leave that tree intact as well if it does go that far over. We're definitely going to be going out and down. We're going to go up to the edge here, and we're going to follow the edge around on this side so that we can leave this canyon down there intact. Okay, so the ceiling should be finished by now. Take a peek. Put them here in the number 10 slot. So how can we recover some of these tiles? Well, let's take a look at the ones in the center. Alright. And let's go ahead and put those down like that, and we'll... So now those are just ceiling tiles. There's nothing underneath them. And all we have to do is change them to foundation cobble, and they're invisible. However, while building... Try that again. I'm going to leave them their natural state so that I can make sure that I can find them, because it's going to make a difference. Okay, we are not going to be able to get a foundation to stick here. Let's try and see if we can't coax it with... Maybe it'll let me stack a foundation on top of it. It's not going to let me put a foundation there. Which is fine. So what we'll do is we're going to go ahead and place a ceiling tile here. And here, okay, like I said, this is not going to be a symmetrical build. However, we are going to need to do some tricks here to get the foundations to work some more. Let me go make some more foundations because I'm going to need them. Foundations. Let's see. Ceiling tiles. Craft all of those. Give me what you've got. Now, let me explain what I meant by making sure that the foundation will connect again. Because I'm laying down ceiling tiles, right? If I take this up and I try to put a foundation, it's not going to snap to the floor. Okay? But it will snap to another foundation. Right? So, if I were, for instance, going to leave this open for like a tunnel or something, the foundations are exactly the same distance apart as if there was a foundation in the middle. And that's kind of what we did, is we used it to draw across a way for it to link up. And, you know, just thinking about that, this would be kind of neat to leave open for like a view down in there. That is something I will take under consideration, because that actually is, I like the idea. And that one's going to be buried. And these need to go forward. So, and we're going to put a triangle foundation in there, I think. And then what we can do here to make this look nifty is we can put a pillar here so it looks supported. Right, and I should have a bird out here. If I had a bird out here, I could fly out real quick and give you a quick peek of what that's supposed to look like. All right, so now this is going to be kind of an issue in that because of the way that the land here is structured, it creates a situation where we're going to have multiple levels. Okay, that's fine. Give me this. Alright. Huh. Can I... It would need to be a... I got it. I know what we'll do. Okay. I am going to use that like I just described. Can we get any more foundations out of here? We cannot. So we're out of metal. That's where our breakdown is currently. We're going to have to go get some more metal. I'll do that in a second. But what I was thinking, I can just take up another foundation real quick. From over here. And one of the things about this set, this mod set, is the walls are higher than... the walls are higher than the standard vanilla walls. Okay? I'll go there, and then those will be stairs down. And because of that, if you try to mix and match different sets, even though they snap, they won't be quite the same. It's like 1.5, roughly, the walls for the castle set to the vanilla set. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and get some more materials, and I will BRBs. Okay, we're back with resources, and we are going to go ahead and make some triangular foundations. We're going to make a couple of both. And we'll go ahead and make a number of other foundations. These, put those in the number 7 slot, and I got a server reboot coming up here really quick. Alright, let's go see how we can use these triangular foundations. Yes, 4 minutes till the world explodes. Okay, so this is a triangular foundation. Okay. By placing it in that manner, you can see now it makes it a little cleaner. And then we can continue with another foundation, potentially. Let's see. We can. And then we would need additional, we would need some additional foundations to continue there. I think I was going to pick up some of these and use some ceiling tiles. Okay, here's my ceiling tiles. I'm going to continue to work on this, and then I'm going to do a server restart real quick. And then we will we'll be able to continue. So go, let me go ahead and log out, and I'll be back in a few. Okay, we're back, and the server's updated. Yay. We are going to put the foundations also on our bar here. And we're going to kind of go through here and recover some more of these foundations by pulling these up here and putting down some more ceilings. Now, ceilings are cheaper to make. One of the problems you might run into using ceiling tiles is if you log out on top of a ceiling tile, you may find yourself in a situation where you wake up under the floor. It happens. I can't give you any more direct detail other than it happens. Now, we are going to have some grass coming through the floor here. I've just kind of learned to overlook it over time for cleaner builds, as far as like having low structures that are kind of low to the ground and whatnot. So that's kind of where we are with that piece of it. Now, this is a little confusing right here. I'm trying to figure out exactly what I want to do. I think I'm going to do this. I'm not sure how big I want my structure to be. This isn't going to be a super duper huge structure. It's just not, it's not what it is. And we're running out of room here, so that is going to be the edge of this corner. Okay. It will encompass the waterfall, which is really what we were looking to do up top, and we will take it all the way to the back. The gamma up here, it looks like it'll be getting dark soon. There's the music. And I do need to make some stairs, because I wanted to show you how we were going to do that area going down. So stairs are found under ramps. And they have ramps as well. I prefer the stairs myself. I think they look sharp. And they connect well. Let's see if we can make that a reality. What does that look like down here? Does it look like it got it all the way? Good enough. Okay, so now, if we come down, boom, there you go. We can get down to this under area. Now, I might stick a... there's not really enough room for a chair under here. Not unless I do some more modifications. This is going to be a thing right here. Okay, when I say a thing, I would like to get another row here, and I guess I can do it. It's going to have a little bit of dirt coming through. So let's go ahead and make some more foundations. Maybe we have some ready? We do. All right, let me get the foundations we have. All right. So we'll pop that down there, that down there, that down there, that down there. Get that little bit of dirt is what I was talking about. When I put a wall there, it'll barely be noticeable. And then this goes across over here. I'd really like to finish that off. Now it's greatly noticeable. But that's right. I think I can live with that. And then we can do this. We can recover this. This. And put those there. I will put stairs here, and that will cover most of it. That'll be the way down. So we'll go back to ramps. Alright, so I'm going to continue building. My goal here is to complete the foundations. You've seen how the foundations work, and you've seen how I've used some of the floors in the foundations to help. It's not working quite as I intended. That's right. It's mostly covered. I'll go ahead and get to where we need to start working with different blocks, and then we'll figure out how to make those work, and I'll show you some techniques in using other types of blocks. So let me go ahead and cut away here, and we'll BRBs. Okay, I wanted to show you another trick. So in trying to expand the foundations, I need to get foundations down here. I'm going to get out of K mode. Alright, so I'm at the bottom of the waterfall, technically. Let me stand up. And I need to bring the foundations down here so I can build on this level. In order to do that, I'm using pillars and I'm coming down. I've gotten to a point now where I can't see my pillar anymore. If I go into K mode and go inside the wall, okay, you can see where the pillar is in through the rock. Because this set has the no clipping on this set works so well, it'll post in walls like that without any issue. Now if I get that on the ground and I grab another pillar and I try to get it to snap all the way down. See if I can get it to work here. I had it down there a second ago. Come on now. Oh, there it is. There it is. See, I got it right there. So now I got that pillar in the wall. Now I'll never be able to recover that pillar. However, what I can do is I can now put a foundation there or there or there. So I think I want a foundation here. Now I realize there might be a little gap there, but that's okay. I'm planning for, see how it's going to hook up with this over here. Fortunately, I'm going to have to go down another level. Now, building in an area like this can be extremely difficult just because there are so many changes in elevation. So let's pick this up. Let's put it down there. Now I can pick that up, and if I can get to it, there it is. Pick that one up. I can recover some of these. Now I want to go up a half a step. So to go up a half step, I can put a pillar here and here, and it'll let me go up a half a step. Okay, so now pick this one up, and then we'll try to get the top pillar first so we don't break the second one. Those up, and then that is there, and then there, okay, then we'll work our way out. Alright, I'm going to try to see if I can't figure out a way to get to that. I can get that. Alright, I have some other tools I can use to try to get that one out. Now, get these plants out of the way. We'll utilize this rock up here as natural terrain. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to put one in there because that's really two in there, actually. To cover up that gap. Okay, let's go take a look. I traded my dragon, or my wyvern, for my bird. So, this is what we've got so far. I can't save the tree on the right. I built around it, and it was taking my foundation way far too far to the right that I really wanted to work with, so I left an empty box there, and we're going to plant a tree there. And then I kind of limited myself on the left-hand side on this side, and I've got a little bit more work here to do, and then that will be done, and then I want to build down below. And that's kind of what I'm working on now, is trying to figure out how to incorporate this water area, and I think we've got a handle on it. I really do. I think we're going to be able to utilize a lot of the space coming across here and going across through to here, and I think we can make that work. That's the plan anyway. It's going to take a lot more foundations. So I just wanted to show you how to get something to snap through the wall using the K-mode, which is the external third-person view mode. It's because you can look under the ground. You can't look through some walls, but you can look through the ground when you have a chance. And it'll allow you to see how things are connecting, so you can try to get things that have that snapping feature with no collision. All right, let me keep working on BRBs. Okay, guys, we ran into something else. So I got the foundations all the way across, and you can see I'm not quite level. I need to go up about two more ceiling heights, essentially. So what I'm doing is I'm playing around with the pillars, and you can see I can like place it here and it's exactly inside of it, or I can go up just a little bit and place it there, or I can go up a half. I want that just a little bit piece, if I can get it to snap. And then when I do that, when I lay down another foundation, I can, if it will snap there, I can get it to go up another half step like that, right? Well, not a half step, but a fraction of a step. But I want it to post on the other side. Doesn't seem to want to. Let's see. Go here. That works. Come up. And it's not going to work there. It's all right. So what I'll do is I'm going to move these to this side, where I've got more ground underneath me. So we'll put that one down. I'll bring that one up the barely a step, and then I've moved it up again. Now we're really close. Okay, and we'll pick all this up. And hopefully this is the last time we have to do this. And then we'll try to get to go up a half to right there. Let's see what it looks like. And you can see that I think it's nearly perfect. Let's see, I can see a bit of a lip on this side and no lip on that side. So considering, right, how far I had to, I took the foundations down there through the water because I had to be able to have the foundations cross all the way across. And then I brought them back up through that jagged area. Let me get a gun out here or something to point with, that dot. I brought it down through here through the water, and then up through here, and then I built it back up to here. Now, this is off. I agree this is not quite right, but it is straight this way, and it is really close. And theoretically, I should be able to put some foundations here and do something like that. And then we'll put some more pillars underneath here to make it look like finished and stuff. So let me show you what I got going on underneath here. So you can see I've got pillars coming across from the sides going through the middle here. And that's to support it because I have no foundations below to count as that. So those pillars look fine. And it's not symmetrical. I kind of dig the not symmetrical part. I'm really liking that this is not a symmetrical build. And when we stand back and we take a look at what we've got so far, it looks like I'm going to put a tower here and a tower there. So I'm going to be changing those foundations out and have them come up and come up. And then I'll build back from there to the top level, right? And that'll be cool. So let me go on to the next step and I'll be our base. All right, guys, we're back. And now we're going to start working with some walls. So I've got a basic layout. And this is going to change. And I've already decided that the layout, while it looks neat, it's got issues. But I still like mostly what I have. And we're going to keep pretty much everything, but it will change as necessary. And so what we're going to do over here is we're going to start creating the effect that this is a wall to keep things out. And to do that, we're going to build down. I believe we're going to build down. I need to jump down there, I think. Well, let me see if it does anything else. Okay, I get that to snap there. Oh, that's good. Great. Let me jump down here. Alright. So we'll go over to this one. Go down. And at this bottom level, we're going to go ahead and put this in. Okay. And it kind of goes down into the water. And that gives it the effect that this has been blocked off by this wall, but the water can go back and forth. And in reality, the water is always going to be there no matter what you do, but gives it the appearance of. Now, it doesn't go all the way to the bottom, but you really can't see that unless you jump in the water, because the water is murky. And we're just going to do that all the way across. And then I may put a gate. Can't imagine why we would need a gate. There's no water dinosaurs that go in there. Now, no gate. If we had water dinosaurs, then I'd consider putting a gate there. Okay, so I've got quite a path built to get up and down there. It's kind of crazy. I'm going to go ahead and make some more walls here. I ran out of materials again. So, in the wall section, let's go over this real quick. We talked about the gables. Those go on stairs to kind of block off the openings left by stairs, and we'll probably use some of those later. And we have inverted regular gables, and we have the keep wall gable end, where two stairs would come together. We have archways, secret door frame. You put a secret door in there, and you can't see it. The only way you know it's there is if you accidentally click on it, or if someone shows you that it's there. They have these diagonals. Those go on the foundations that are diagonal, that are not completely square. And they have the arrow loops. Okay, doorways. With this is on a curved wall. This is a arrow loop on a curved wall. You have normal walls. There are two types of door frames. There's wooden and stone structure that go around those. And you also have a more ornamental doorway and an ornamental doorway on a diagonal. And let's see what else we have. So there's our stone windows. Round wall, normal, diagonal wall, normal, and your normal arrow loop wall. So we're working with the straight walls. And we want to go up a level here. We want to go to prison. And we want to get another set of prison bars. Probably two. Okay. Go back up a level here. Let's grab a couple more walls. Or a wall. And see if this is enough to build with for a bit. I'm going to go on another material run. I've only been four times. So we're bringing about 5,500 ore back a trip. I've been four times. Kind of give you an idea how much material this kind of a build takes with this mod set. Alright. So let's start building the next one over. Might as well just jump down in the water. Let me break that rock and get rid of this. Get this out. I'm afraid to get my feet wet, apparently. Alright, let's get rid of the weight in case we have to run from something. Alright, go back to do number 9. There. And then we'll bring down one more row. right? And we are almost out of walls at this point. Okay. So that is how we use some of these walls. We can build down off of the ceilings. So that really works out for us. And I have enough pillars there to act. Pillars act as foundations as far as like how far you can build away from a particular block. Normally it's two foundations away. A third foundation requires either another foundation or a pillar type to do that. And so I'm kind of tying it together with pillars. We're going to wall in that entire section. So from this side, it will look like a solid wall. And that's kind of the appearance we want to give. And those walls will keep out any of the dinos. These are considered metal walls. And they give the same protection weather-wise, heat-wise, as adobe. So it's basically, it's got both effects. You get the hardness of metal and the protection of adobe. Okay, well, I'm going to go ahead and do some more resource runs, and I'm going to keep building, and I'll BRBs, folks. Okay, we're back. And we have fixed this area here. And now we can use gables. So let me show you what I did here. Go into K-mode. You can see I laid some foundations under the ground. Or not foundations. Some ceiling tiles under the ground. And I'm going to use those to connect these gables to and walls and kind of build that up to that side over there. And it should look pretty good, I'm guessing. Get out of this mode here. Click on this. So there's a gable. There's a wall. There's a gable. Okay. So from this side, this looks finished. And then what we'll do is it looks like we're going to extend this ceiling over one more this direction so we can get a nice tight fit. Because we have an outside wall we want to finish. Luckily, because I redid it, it brought it down just enough that it should sink the whole thing into the dirt, except for maybe right in this low spot. So let me go make some more walls. Let's see, walls. I have one gable left. I'm going to need a ceiling too. At least one. I got some resources. I broke one, so I got some resources on me. Right, there's some walls and a ceiling. Put that in there. Number 7 slot. Okay. Put this gun away. That's a bad thing to have out. That gun that I had out isn't actually a gun. It will let you pick up objects at range, which I find to be very useful, but it's also very skittish and it breaks a lot of stuff. Okay, so I want to do that and that. Okay, so now that is a thing. All right, let's go ahead and take this one, that one. That's how that looked right there. Okay, it is actually sinking, so that's good. And we're about to lock ourselves out. So I got a gable. Where's my other gable? I'm not going to put a gable on this side. If I did, I'd have to use E to flip it around. So E flips it. But the thing is, I'm going to have this be... this is a defensive outer wall. So it needs to have no way for enemies to like jump through this crack. Because if I put a gable there, enemies could technically just jump through that gap. So we're not... That gap. So we're not going to do that. So I'm going to go ahead and keep building. You can see I've got some foundations here. So for a tower, we're going to do a round tower there. I wanted to do one over here. There's just not enough space. I'm not exactly sure what we're going to do over here yet. It's still kind of in the I don't know stage. But we'll get there eventually. And let me keep on getting some stuff, and I'll BRBs. Okay. We're back again. And this time, we're going to build some stairs. But this time, we're going to build circular stairs. Let me go to ramps. And we have options and or left and right. Right go clockwise, left go counterclockwise. We are going to do right stairs. I'll build two of them. Now there's a trick to these, and you have basically you have to use the E key when you do the second set. I'm gonna throw these on here. I'm pretty weighted down. I got a lot of walls on me, so we're making some progress here. Whoa, that was a interesting thing. Okay, so you can see how this is kind of developing here. I like it. Let me go ahead and put some walls down. I have a rounded wall and a rounded wall with an arrow loop. So my stairs are going to start over here. So we're going to put the rounded wall with the loop right there. So that way you can technically shoot out should you have a need. And then the stairs, I'm going to grab those. I'll try to get them to start in the right spot. Start here. So you can have access to here, but then you can start going upstairs. Now, when you go to do the stairs to go to the next level, it doesn't want to snap to the right spot unless you hit E. You hit E, you should be able to get them to snap to the right location so you can continue up. That's kind of the trick with these. We are going to make some changes to the inside of this to make sure that this stairwell will work. We need to keep building that up. Let me get rid of some of these walls that we've got. Let's see. Get rid of that. So this is as high as this room is going to be. The tower is going to go above it. This is going to be the height of the castle. Alright guys, we're back again. As you can see, we've gotten double walls pretty much all in this upper part. And I added some of these. They're called lancets. And they have different options of lancets. I can't do it here. I can show you on the table real quick. And some of them are two walls high. There might be some that are three walls high. So you go under walls, glass, lancet. I know it's pretty bright because I got my gamma turned up. But you've got this option here, which is for a taller wall. This looks like it's like two wide and like three high, and this one maybe is one wide and three high. And you know, there's just different options. I like that option. I just wanted to be able to let some extra light in from above, and I put them up. So then we're also going to be doing these railings to keep people like me from falling in to our death. So I'm just going to go around and toss up a few of these. And I'm going to be making some modifications to this. Not sure what yet. Let me go ahead and finish putting these railings up. I'm sure I didn't make enough. So there you could be able to come and stand here and look out over the valley. Okay, I'm going to need quite a few more to do the other side of this. And as you can see, I've got doors here for entering into this upper area. So the functional area is up above. Lower area is really, it's all for looks, you know. Let me go ahead and put this here and see if I can get this in. This is a diagonal. Should cover that space nicely. Right. And I got a gable left. Let's see if I can get a gable to work here. Not sure if I can. Just because of how the foundation and the stairs are working. It's only a half step down. Because it's a half step down, it's not going to work. So here's the question. Now, I know that this is all interior. This is going to still be an exterior wall going around here. And I'll probably bring the exterior wall. I'll probably stop it here at the circle, and then we'll go with railings. Can anything get in this way? Not really. Okay, that works. That's what we'll do. All right, back to work. I'll be back in a bit. Okay, guys, we're back. We've been working on this little area here inside this little garden, and you can see I've planted some trees and some bushes and flowers and whatnot, and we're just trying to put up these tall glass windows so that you can really get a good look at these at the garden area. Now, of course, that's going to stay open all the way to the roof, to the other level. I need to create one more of those, and we're still going through resources like crazy. So it's under walls, glass, lancets, and we've been using this one here. We've been using the keep tall double lancet window structure, and that will be the last one we need. And basically, we're almost out of crystal again. I had to make a crystal run. And this should do this room here and completely lock it off. Bam, like so. Okay. And then, of course, there will be no roof on it, and it's got a tree in it. It's kind of cool. I like it. And this, I don't like using these kinds of doorways because if there's a step up, you tend to get caught on the edges when you go through. However, I don't expect to be going out there very often. It's more of a decorative thing than a functional thing. We do need to make some ceilings, though. That's probably a good number. Let's go ahead and let those cook up. See if I can give you another quick show around of anything else we've done. I got this pretty much set up to what I want it to look like. Now, what you'll notice is this corner here. You can potentially fall down in here. And I was going to create this anyway. I'll go ahead and show you right now what you can do with that. Let me go back in here. Let's clear the craft queue. We're going to go to ceilings. And then they have these circular rounded. I'm not sure which one we need. Even if I look at it in my mind and picture it, this would be the one that I think would fit the picture, but it's probably not the one. I'll probably end up coming back and making the other one. But let's see if we can get this one to fit. Now, what this will do is this will put, like, I don't know, kind of a railing that'll make it so you won't fall down in there if it fits. Let's see if I can get it to go in. Let's press E. And like so. I think that will work. It'll keep us from actually being able to get in there and fall down, okay? So that is what that will do. And we'll go back and finish our ceilings now. Because we'll need a lot of them. Let's see. Give me all of them. Take what you got. Put them in an 8 slot. Okay, so I have been having quite a time with this area here. I've got this all railed out across. So this is done. We've got to do the walls here. I'm going to figure out what I want to do here. I think I'm going to do a diagonal or a round here. I'm not sure which. And I may actually change this some so that this gives more space in here. I don't know yet. But if we come back this way and go down here, this area is going to be sealed in. Okay, I've got some work to do. You can see there's about a half of a foundation difference there. I got to fix that. This one's going to be open on this side, and it's going to be walled on this side, and there will be no top. And this is going to be completely open. So this is going to change to a door. And you have to exit out of the door, and I'm going to add a door here to go back into a structure on this side. Because I cannot actually put that area in a wall because of the lack of foundations. Okay? And then this down here is just going to be rails. If I do that, there will be a door right here. Okay, and then there'll be rails out there. And then this is going to be internal all over here, including the bridge. It's going to be internal and then we'll worry about this side last. Okay. So there's a lot going on. Starting to take some shape. And there's a lot of things in here like this, the change in elevation. It is just, it is what it is. It's just, it takes a lot of manipulation. And then when I get to some difficult parts, I'll bring you back so that you can see where we are with that. Okay. So let me continue working. I'll BRBs, peeps. All right, guys, we're back. This is what we have that I have figured out here. Okay. So on the step downs, or on this side, you'll see, I'll land here so you can see, I'll turn it. There is, K mode, a small deviation on the roof. Okay. This section that my bird is standing on is one fraction lower than the high walls on that lower section down there. However, I think that is considered to be acceptable because it's going to be barely noticeable. All right. What I've got to do, though, is I've got to get in here and get these walls to actually mount to the ceiling piece lower like that to get this to be... I'm going to get back down there. Snug. Okay. And considering how much of the elevation changed, and then that's the only difference, if I wasn't in a hurry to try to get this all done, probably wouldn't have had any issue at all. But as it is what it is. So I can live with that. And you know what? Unless I point it out to people, no one will probably ever notice it. Just like I did here. Okay. So let me keep building. And next time I run into something I find out, I will let you know and bring you back in. BRBs, peeps. Okay, guys. We're back again. And we have created something pretty cool. So here's something you should probably know. Because of the shift in the foundations, you see that wall that's missing right there? I've put it up there twice. Every time I change anything to this area, it breaks that one wall. And I can't tell you why, but just be prepared that that would be something that would happen. I replaced this. This used to be an archway. I replaced it with a door. It broke. I fixed it. This used to be an archway. I replaced it with a door. It broke. I fixed it. I mean, I didn't fix it. So that's just one of the hazards of the foundation shifts. Sometimes you'll take something, you'll move something, pick something up, and something else will break. Usually it happens with stairs, but in this case, it was that particular wall. So I've got this, the height, I'm going to leave it. That's, this whole area down here is going to be four walls high, I guess. I got a lot of walls to put in here still. Back this way, I put in these arrow loops for defensive purposes. I'm not going to do too much in decoration over here. I am thinking about making a stairway that goes up, then it goes over, and it goes up, it goes over, and it'll basically go up, and that's kind of the idea. I'm kind of out of resources right now. And then I did another elevation change here. I think I'm getting better at it. You can see here, this platform we've had forever, I got stairs down to a platform, stairs down again, and then now I got it so you can get down to the water and you can actually drink. I'm full of water, I can't actually drink anymore, but and then I was able to add railings because I added these pieces here. If you add those, it'll allow you to put railings in these particular situations. So essentially what we had is every foundation that you move off with the pillar is a half drop. So if you do it twice, it's a full drop. Sometimes you'll get that little bump, which is what we ended with up here, where we have that real little change right there. And you just have to be careful, make sure that doesn't happen. It's too late to go back and fix that now. All right, guys. So let's go through another part of this this mod here. We've worked on ceilings, we've worked on walls, we've worked on doors, we've worked on foundations, elevation changes, some other tricks. And so let's go ahead and get into some other options we have with the mod. So one of the things that we can work with is the fireplace. Okay. we need to build, we'll build a couple of them. And with that, we're going to need to build a chimney. So let me go ahead and buy some create some chimneys with that. We need some minting paste, and I don't have any on me to make the other items we need. So let me go ahead and fly back real quick and grab some. I'll just grab emerald here. And just take a second. It's just around the corner. And this will give me an opportunity to kind of show you the other base, that the one that we actually are functionally using on this server currently. So there's several mods on the server, but the primary one the structure is built with is the Castles, Keeps, and Forts mod. Go ahead and land. And there's a lot going on here. So that's the elevator back there. That's kind of cool. That was fun to build. So, you know, we built like a birdhouse over there for birds. And we have our main building here, which is where we do most of our, it holds most of our equipment as far as machines go. And we use this under here for storage. It's easy to access. You just can walk under here and it's covered. It'll actually protect you from the storm if you're in there. And the cementing paste should be in our here, I believe. We have cementing paste in here. That should be plenty. Okay. I can go ahead and demonstrate how the fireplaces work in here. So we've got two of them, one on each side of this room. Okay. This fireplace up here, it has a cooking pot in it. And it works like the, what's it called? The industrial... The industrial cooker. It works like the industrial cooker. It's irrigated. I've got water coming to it from the outside. Not sure if we can still see these pipes because I have them hidden. We use the mod that lets us hide our pipes, but you can see it's fully irrigated right there. And basically you put your ingredients in here, right? And then you go down here and it has a separate area for your wood. And it runs on wood. You just put wood in there, and you can, or whatever burns, and it'll go ahead and cook whatever's in the cooking pot. Okay, so that's kind of cool. You don't need electricity, and you can get the effect of the industrial cooker. And the same thing on this side, except that this one, as you can cook meat, like the what's it called, the industrial grill. I believe that's what it's called, grill. Yeah, the industrial grill. So it works like the industrial grill, and it runs on oil as well. Okay. It's also a good way to make charcoal, and then you can have the chimneys go up to the roof. When they go up to the roof, they look like this right here. Okay. One on each side, nothing special. And like I was saying, we have a mod in here that we use that allows us to hide electrical and pipes. So that's what we do there. You know, head on back with I've got this, and we'll go ahead and make the other things and put them in, and then we'll look to see what else we can get make real quick. And we'll try to go through and make sure we knock out everything. We're almost done with this mod and all the functionality. And what I'll do is once I've covered everything, I'll go ahead and try to finish the structure, at least button it all up. Come on. And then I'll come back and show you a finalized version of a quick build of this, because it could be much more grand. I just didn't have that assigned for this particular video. Throw that in there. Now we can go in here and go to our fireplace, and we can create our rotisserie and our cooking pot. Now, getting water to the cooking pot is a different story. Okay, so I've got all those. And I would guess that since the water is in this general vicinity, I'd want to put one of them here. Don't have to. It's not required. I forgot the fireplaces. There we go. And I probably want to put one of these here. Need my fireplace. Now, they're a little weird to place. If you place them too close to the wall, here's another tip. You may find that putting other, accessing the inventory could be a problem. So you actually want to come back just a tad from the wall. When I say a tad, I mean just a very small amount. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start back here. Okay. And I'm going to line this up to make sure that I have no deviation. Okay. That seems pretty straight to me. And then I'm going to put it in the middle of the space. I'm going to walk all the way up. Okay. Until I see the back bricks enter the wall. And then I'm going to come out just a tad. And we're going to go up and see if we can access the inventory. Okay, we can't. This first one is going to be the pot, the cooking pot. So we'll go ahead and put this in. It snaps right there. I think the water snaps like right on this side. And it will then be able to see it's not irrigated. And power is, it says unpowered because it doesn't have any fire burning materials in it. If I were to put something in here, if I have anything that burns on me, which I don't. If I put it in there and light it, then it would say it was powered. So that's where that goes. Fireplace, chimney. Go right there. There's a roof, will go right around that without any issue. And since we've got a fireplace there, we might as well go ahead and put one over here. Just checking to see if that's pretty much centered. Now, when you do identical items and you're trying to place them and make sure that they're straight, one of the things I like to do is I will try to line it up with an existing one, okay? And by doing that, I will try to find where it is pretty much equal to what we've been working with. And it works really well with the storage boxes, the large storage boxes. So I would say that that is pretty close. Now if I walk this over here, and let me double check that spacing there. Okay, so it's about that much space. Push it back until it disappears. Mounts a little bit. And there it goes. So it's really close there. Looks like it might be a little closer here. It is a little closer on the other one. It's not a big deal. Everything in this mod set you can pick up and move. So because this doesn't work as well as the things like the storage box, I'm gonna go ahead and do this one just by lining it up on this floor area here. Okay, that's pretty good. And then just walk it back, pop it out. Okay, make sure I can access the inventory. Good. We'll take the rotisserie piece. Pop that right in there. And it's kind of a done deal. Now, another tip. If you walk up this to put meat in it, all right, and you read it and you press E, you're not close enough to actually, I'm pressing F. I can't actually get it. You actually got to walk up to it until it gives you the access inventory. Otherwise, you'll just end up picking it up and it's back in your inventory. And you have to put it back in there again. Okay? So you got to get really close to it until it changes this access inventory. And the fireplace works the same as the other. Okay? And then let's just throw a chimney on that guy. And there you go. And of course, we can change the color on these, or the texture, to whatever we like. Okay? I'll go back to graystone, because that's kind of what we're building over here for right now. So that takes care of that piece. Now let's go look and see what else we've got in here. Okay, we've worked with railings. We've worked with fireplaces. We have a chimney extension in case you need to go through higher. If your room is higher than too high, you can use the extension to take it up to the next level. Prison, we've done... the roofs. Okay, I'm going to come back to that because I need to actually have something to put a roof on. Mark of the Maker. Okay, we'll go ahead and make one of those. I'll show you what these look like. These are just little decorative pieces that you can make to put on your build. They're all the same, but you can change them. So I can go over here and I can place it. So they're all like this triangular thing that we're looking at right here. And we'll just kind of place it like right here. Right? Then you can go up to it and you can change it to different textures that stands out. Yeah, so that's the Hellfire option. And it's basically, that's all it does. It's decorative. All right. Let's see what else we got here. The stable bedding. It's supposed to provide a warm and cozy environment for precious eggs. So I'm assuming, okay, I haven't tested it, that it will change the variance of temperatures around an egg to give it, to put it closer to where it needs to be in order to be able to be hatched. That's what I'm assuming that it does, but I've never actually tested that. Gates, we've done all but this large gate. Basically, it's a 3-high tile, and you put this keep gate inside of it, and it opens and closes. You cannot, in this particular map, I cannot get a camelosaurus. I'm trying to think of their moss, Moralotops. Moralotops will not go through that gate. However, Anklos will. And so there is a limit to what can fit outside that gate. We also have the Behemoth Gate. The Behemoth Gate is huge. I can show you one of those. I'm not making one for the structure. We can get back to that in a minute. We've got spiral staircases, which you've seen. Ramps, which is basically, it's a ramp, no big deal. And the stairs. Let's see, let's go down to, we've seen the walls. We've seen most of these walls. We haven't seen the secret door wall. I guess we can make one of those. And make a door to go with it. Let's see if I can find a place to put it. These work really kind of cool. I mean, you really can't tell that they're there. I don't really have a place that I can think of on this particular build that we can add a secret door. However, we'll go down here and we'll put one in this corner. So this is gonna, actually probably can't. We'll do it for right now anyway. So we'll put the secret door down and we'll put the door that goes inside it. So it just looks like a wall, but if you walk up and press E, it opens and slides like that, and that's how it works. Okay, that's what that does. Let me go run back up real quick. We'll take a shortcut. Okay, what else is left here? I think we're pretty much running out of options. Walls, pillars we played with, battlements. We haven't done too many of those. So you have curved, and you have two designs. You have the looped, and you have the crenulated. So the looped basically looks like a wall with these in it, right? A little battlement with those in it. I like the crenulated. They look a little bit better. And if you're actually trying to make them functional, which they can be, then they actually work much better. So I'll make one of each so you can see them. I'll actually make a couple of these because I'm going to be using those. And let this hurry up and build. Let's see what else we got left here after battlements. We played around with the ceilings. We haven't played around with the curved ceilings too much and the hatch frame. I can tell you the hatch frame from experience, it can be troublesome. Be prepared to pick it up and put it down several times. It's like when you put up a hatch frame and a ceiling tile, it's only one side really wants to let the ladder that you put on it to fit. And you might have to pick it up like from, you know, place it, doesn't work. Okay, well, it doesn't work that way, so we'll try placing it this way. And you might have to place it a couple times in order to get it to where the ladder is on the side that you want it on. And I've run into that numerous times. I've got to get on the roof. I've got some roof up there. Maybe I can land a dragon on it. I don't really have access. Yes, I do. I have access to the roof. I changed this around yesterday. Okay, we have access to a roof. So if we're putting down battlements, okay, so here's one option, and it's backwards. The reason I know it's not backwards, that's correct. So if I wanted to shoot down low, you know, I have that much of an opening. If this whole wall is like that, that's kind of sucky. But if I have this one and I want to shoot down low, I can really move around and I can see a good deal more. I can't quite get as close to the building, but I can see, I have a wider view. And you can actually jump, walk over these if you're not careful, right? And this give you an idea what they're going to look like. That's what they'll look like. So they actually look really nice. I need to put another ceiling there. Okay. What else we got in here? I think that's pretty much it. Ceilings. Yep. Foundations. Okay. So I believe this sums up the demo part, or the explanation how the different pieces work and how we use them. I think the what I'll do now is I'm just going to go ahead and cut away and try to get like a fairly finished structure, come back and show you the finished product, right? I will BRBs in a while. All right, I think we have something to show. Whew, okay, this took a while. I have one last thing to do that I wanted to show you. I have not yet shown you how, correct, how to place roofs on round structures. So I have in my inventory four of these roofs. Now what you'll see how it's like turning green and it's not really doing, what I figured out is when you're doing round towers especially, you place it and you hit E. It pops it right around. Okay? Place it, hit E, and it always seems to fit just like it's supposed to. There you go. That's how you put on a roof. Now, let's go ahead and take a quick flyover and see what we've got on the outside. This looks pretty cool. I would definitely work to upgrade this in the future, but I'm going to go ahead and turn gamma up a little bit. So we can see, okay, so from the facing the waterfall direction, this is kind of what we've got here. We've got the area down below in the water with the grates, or the prison bars that to allow water in and out, so that's a thing. We have the ability to shoot arrows from the protection of the walls through the arrow loops in the front. We have a tower in the front that has stairs up, right? Going around this side. This side provides protection from anything down below. And then, let me go ahead and land. And walking up the side here, this area is all protected here, and you can see arrow loop there, also some arrow loops here, right? And then we can go ahead and go inside. Inside, of course, we've built the sanctuary here with the tree and the garden. Okay, I added some pillars for effect. They're not required. The ceiling will stay up just fine on its own. But I added the pillars to kind of give it the show of some stability. If I added another set of pillars, it probably wouldn't be bad either. Looking the other side of the building, we've got windows, and we have a door to exit with, so we can exit out of this door as well. Potential growth opportunities going that way as far as increasing the size of your base. On this side, we have the door that comes down into the center courtyard that has the waterfall, and we can look down below. We have stairs that go up and made the whole area over here defendable. Okay, we have access from up here to shoot, and we have good visibility from here. Coming around here, we have the ability to go underneath. We have some storage area. We also have some arrow loops here to allow for more defense. So this side is now completed. If you remember when we first started, we added this little area down here so you can kind of get down here and you can just kind of sit down and enjoy the view next to the mist coming off the water. And of course this is all railed in here so you can't fall off. This side, I made some changes. I basically tore it down and redid part of this here so there's no more anomaly. It's just this goes to here, the door, and then this part is outside and you can look to the courtyard again. And then this here is unprotected. That's why there's a door here. And that's why there's a door here. This is basically unprotected space, right? Any dinosaurs that get in through here, no big deal. This is also the most dangerous part of the build because there's no railings. Come down into this area, very high ceiling, and go down to the inner courtyard, down to where the water is, so you can drink water. Use this for a water source to put water in the base wherever you need it. We have a functional tower here with stairs that go up. I added an arrow loop here and some floors before continuing up. I need to put a railing right there. I don't think I have any left on me. I do not. There should be a railing there and a door there. And then these battlements are completely functional here. You have the ability to shoot or view all of this area, and it goes all the way over to this side over here. I was going to put stairs on this side, decided I didn't need them because I had stairs here. They're fairly centrally located. And then, of course, this area down here, you have arrow loops to shoot out through there, and you've got the room over here. Very, very tall room. You could potentially add some storage area up above here if you wanted to, and continue walking back this way just by putting in a set of stairs. So that concludes the base build using Castles, Keeps, and Forts mod. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and I look forward to creating more videos showcasing some of the mods that we use in Ark Survival that make our lives easier. So if you liked it, push the like button, subscribe to the channel. We're doing streams all the time, my buddies and I here on the server. And thank you for watching. Later, peeps.